So, just gonna show you this little bit. So, very important. Go to replic.com. Then you click up top right, new replic. Then you click here. We'll set up. We'll automatically give you a title, but you can give it any title you want. This is my first replic. Now, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter if you get this. Doesn't matter what you do with this one. Yeah, you need to click create replic. They will be public unless you pay for it. So you may. So, but right now we're just playing about. So don't pay anything too personal up there. Keep it public for now. And then it will set you up with this page. Keep everything on there to start off with, because by because you'll this stuff here, you'll need it later. Whenever you click run, it'll update everything you've done. Since I've had it, hello, Cuthbert. So, hello, welcome back to my another one of my demonstration videos. I'm gonna try and show you as quickly as I can how to make your own website. Now, I don't think you'd have to go to university to make your own website, so I'm gonna try and show you. Now, it might not be the best one. If you've got loads of money in a big company, maybe go to Squarespace or whatever. But if you just wanna have a bit of a play, make your own just for fun, which is the quickest way to do it. Right. Number one, you can go on W3 schools. That's what we use a lot at university, and you can go through their exercises, and they will teach you everything you need to know. And well, I want to try and, but if you want to cut for your corners, I'll try and show you in 5 minutes how to cut for your corners. Firstly, go to this website called Replit. Okay. Replit.com. It's free to sign up, absolutely free to sign up. And but your code isn't actually free. If you don't subscribe, then your code isn't free. So don't put anything too personal on there, or just copy and paste it somewhere else, whatever. And when it gets big and important, properly pay. But if you just want to play and have a bit of fun and try and make your own website, then this is the way to go. And start yourself a new one. They'll give you an automatic name, but you can rename it yourself if you want. They start you off with this text up here. Do not delete that to start off with, because that it may become useful later on. That first line, that's telling the browser that is a doc type HTML document, so a browser can read it. Telling browser that it can read this HTML in here, that's also doing the same thing. And every time you're issuing a command, then it's going to be inside these kind of like triangular brackets. Every command is going to be inside these triangular brackets, so like that. And then you need to close it with a similar one with a backslash there, or forward slash, with the same kind of command, and that will close it. And you need to do that for anything you do. That's what you've got to do. The header, this is like, it's information about the page, but it's not actually going to be part of the going to be shown, but it's going to be important, because it's important for your page. It's going to be important for the browser to understand what's going on in your page. Meta char set, that's the character set. Meta name, viewport, content width, device width, that means it's going to be this. Leave that in, because that means it's going to be the width of the width of your page will be the width of the device they're watching on. Whether that could be a mobile phone, or it could be a tablet, or it could be a computer. Title. It's the title of the page. This will be at the top. So DGMC Bane, that is the other page here. That's the title of the page. You can change that to whatever you want. So the simplest website ever. Style sheet. That style sheet tells is like that's where you put all your stuff like the background, the colors, and CSS stands for cascading style sheets, which helps with the decor, the aesthetic, to make your website aesthetically pleasing. Because you can just type in here. And it will just come out very simply, and that's available on the internet now. But if you want to make it look good, then you're going to need stuff like cascading style sheets, and that's linked to that in there. So now, if you want to, you can nick this from me. I use the same, roughly the same style sheet each time. Since then, I've got better at this. I don't actually have to do this anymore. But and then you can change all these colors yourself. Basically, that means we're going to go back to the page now. So. That's all we need to have in the header. The body. This is the body of the web page of the website. And in that body, you need some content, something you're going to write about. If it's going to be first we want a header. For a header, you put H1. This is the header. And it's already done. It's automatically closed it for me. If you want a slightly smaller header, so say a subheader, now they go all the way down to H5, I believe it is. Now, the reason why they're coming up in different colors is because in this CSS file, I've told it so that all the H1, all the biggest headers, to go to be this color and to be and to have that background, but you could change it yourself. And P, that is what we're going to come to next. P means it's a paragraph. So. Is a paragraph of content. Every time start a new paragraph, you should start it with a P. how do you put an image in? So, firstly, you can find your image you want. So let's go to let's get an image of a bird. Let's get a stock image of a bird. Now what you can do is you can view the image, providing it's a free image to use. You can then copy and paste a link to it, and it will, and then this is the way where if you don't actually have the image yourself, you can link to it elsewhere on the, if the image is elsewhere on the internet, you can link it to it there. So you have to do that, and what you do is you go open the triangular brackets, image, SLC means source, there you go. There's another way to do an image, where if you have an image on that's on your computer, it's yours. So let's go, so if we go to save image as stock bird. Then you're going to download where you've saved it. Copy it across over to here. So then, now instead of going a link to it, all I've got to do is put a link to that little page there instead of going all the way across the internet. Some things need to be in quotation marks, especially if it's a name of anything, it's got to be in the quotation mark. Then pick your height for it. Width. Alt, that'll be the name for it. That'll be an alternative name for it. actually, if you want to got a video on YouTube you want to put into your website, then very, very easy. They basically, YouTube have made it very easy for you to do that. It's almost like they designed it for this. Do is click share, embed, copy and paste this, there you go. Now you can change the size of it. Let's make it a little bit thinner so it doesn't stick out so much. There you go, so that's how you've got a header, a couple of pictures, and a video, and I'll show you how to make a link, so you might want to create a link to another page. To one of my other ones because I've already got it, so it's a lot easier to copy and paste than it is to actually write out yourself. So if you have any way of copying and pasting, always pick that. So here we are. Now I'll pick a link that I've already got here. So is link there. That link to the other website, and if you want to, you can make that link a picture. If I copy and paste this bird into that gap, that A command, that is a link. That's everything in between that first part and the second part. That click on anything in between that, that'll be the link. And that's done. Now, this is the most simple, basic possible website to make. There's a way to make it a lot better than that and do a lot more things with it, but if you just want to have a play about with it, and if you ever get stuck, go to W3 Schools. They've got a lot of stuff here to help you and work your way through that if you want. And Replit, as I say, this is the best platform to use if I were you. Every time you click run, it refreshes it, and any changes you've made, you can refresh and you'll see what's happened to them straight away. You can use this to go back to a previous version, and that is the simplest, quickest demonstration video. There's a lot more to learn than that, and I'll cover that in a later video. Thank you.